Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video we are going to discuss the preparation strategy for RBI grade B examination. So recently there was a notification for RBI grade B, and for general category vacancies are 130. For OBC category there are 28 vacancies, and coming to SCST, the vacancies for RBI grade B are 20. So now let's see what is the exam pattern and what is the preparation strategy. And coming to exam pattern, quantitative questions will be asked, like 30 quantitative ability questions will be asked, and each question will carry 1 mark. So coming to quantitative ability, it is not so easy and not so difficult kind of section. It is a moderate section where few questions which they ask will be indirect, and which time consumes, which consumes more and more time. So when you get stuck for a particular question, it's better to move on to the next question, because you will be having only one, you'll be having in total 200 questions and there will be 200 marks. So for question you'll be having only 1 mark and 1 minute per question. So if you allocate more than 1 minute for that question, later you'll be running out of the time, so you'll not be having time to recheck the doubtful question. So what you need to do is, when you feel the question is time consuming in quantitative aptitude particularly, just skip the question, and if you have time later you can come back to that question. And next, coming to English, you'll be having 30 questions, and time also you have to allocate as like maximum of 30 minutes, like 1 mark for one question. And English, like most of the students will feel English is very easy subject, so we can study in just last 20 days or last 1 month. That is not the case, because coming to English, it looks like the easy section, but it will be the one of the most confusing section, because answers will be really confusing. And coming to English, it's not that easy to prepare in the last moment. So make sure you give the reasonable and equal time to English as well. And coming to general awareness, we should have the knowledge about the current affairs and related to general knowledge questions and all, and 80 questions from general awareness will be appearing, and for one question there will be 1 mark allocated. So, and coming to reasoning is not that easy section, because the questions will be a bit confusing. So now let's see what are the important topics for each section. Okay, so coming to reasoning, you have to concentrate more on coding and decoding and syllogism, and the questions from data sufficiency will appear, and blood relations questions will also appear. And most important topic from reasoning is data sufficiency, coding, decoding, and arrangement. Okay, arrangement of the people, like the questions may be appeared in any form, like they may ask seating arrangement, or they may ask arranging people, linear arrangement, circular arrangement. And these arrangement questions will be really logical questions, so they will consume more and more time. So practice more and concentrate more on this arrangement questions, because once you practice, you'll feel it easy. Otherwise, you in exam, I'm sure that you're going to stuck at this particular question, because it looks easy but not at all easy. So concentrate more on data sufficiency and arrangement problems. And coming to problems like directions will appear for sure, that speed, distance and time problems will be a bit difficult compared to other questions and time consuming. And syllogism questions will be also appearing. And coming to quantitative aptitude, the most important chapters are time and work, speed, distance and time, permutation and combination, data interpretation, mensuration. These five chapters should be given more time because these chapters are having high weightage in the exam, like RBI grade B. So, and the thing is, the questions from permutation and combination probability will appear for sure and having high weightage, and the questions will also appear from the easy chapters such as LCM, HCF and type average ratios and all. So coming to English, you have to concentrate more on error spotting, because error spotting is a question, like the questions will be asked where it will be really confusing. So coming to error spotting, the more you practice, the more easy it becomes. So concentrate more on error spotting and passage making, and you know, this reading comprehension, like whenever they ask you reading comprehension, make sure you read the passage within 30 to 40 seconds of time, because at max of 50 seconds, because if you give more than 1 minute for just reading passage, it's not going to be sufficient, like that you are going to run out of the time, because reading passages will be a bit lengthy coming to this particular exam. So make sure you read so well with concentration, and make sure you remember the important points, so that I suggest coming to this passage and reading comprehension, what I suggest is, it's better for you to read the questions first and then read the paragraph, like the passage, because once you read the question, you will automatically concentrate on the question related passage and the question related paragraph. Okay, so concentrate more on the error spotting and reading comprehension, and filling the blanks will be relatively easy compared to other questions, and concentrate more on jumbling words also. And that's it, these are the few important topics where you have to concentrate more on. And coming to general affairs, you have to have the knowledge about last 6 months, like minimum of last 6 months current affairs in India, and you have to have knowledge about the economy, and they'll be asking you the general knowledge questions, and you also have to concentrate on the Indian financial system, and what are the terms which are used in the banking and the banking system, types of banking procedures, and what are the monetary plans, what is monetization, all those things will be asked in general awareness. So out of the four sections of reasoning, quant, English and general awareness, easy section is the quantitative aptitude comparatively compared to remaining three sections, and next easiest section is English, and next is the reasoning, and you have to concentrate more on reasoning as well as general awareness, because general awareness, the more you practice, the more you remember, because make sure you are aware of all the current affairs which happened for last 6 months minimum, and 6 to 8 months. And another important thing for this is, as this is RBI grade B exam, the people who set the question paper, like they will expect you to have the complete knowledge about RBI and the technical terms used in the RBI and the monetary plans and the recent implementations which happened in RBI and all those stuff. And other thing is, coming to this particular exam, you have to have concentrate, like you have to concentrate more on your time management, because you'll be having 20 like 200 questions and 200 marks and a limited period of time. So if you get stuck in one particular question, you'll be running out of the time for sure. So make sure you If you don't get the answer, it's fine. Just skip to the next question and solve it. And if you are left out with the time, then you can just come back again. There's no worry. And now coming to the tips which I want to give for this RBI Grade B exam to in order to get good rank on in order to qualify is that what you need to do is first refer to all the previous papers, like you know the last 5 to 6 years of RBI Grade B examination previous papers. If you refer, then you will get the knowledge of what questions, like what type of questions are repeating every year and what sort of questions are being asked in the exam and the stuff like that. And make sure you give mock tests daily. Like if you give mock tests daily, what happens is you will know how much time you are taking for that particular section or that particular question. So it really helps. And if you give mock tests daily, you'll like gradually you'll reduce the time consumption, and you can solve the problems, like solve the questions very easily and within less time. For the final exam, like the main exam and the prelims. And other tip which I would like to give is concentrate more on the weightage. Like I have told you few important topics which are there for each and every section. Concentrate more on that. It doesn't mean that you just completely ignore others. You have to concentrate more on these particular topics, as well as you have to refer to previous papers and also concentrate on other topics also. And if you find any topic difficult, then make sure you see the previous year paper and from that particular chapter what kind of questions are repeating, mark them and practice only those kind of things. Because instead of ignoring the chapter completely, which you feel difficult, at least make sure you practice the important problems from that chapter, okay? So that you know, for these kind of exams, every point and every mark matters. So make sure you does not leave any chapter for choice or any chapter for like you know feeling it as hard. And other tips I would like to give is set your everyday goals, okay? Today I have to complete this chapter, okay? And since morning to evening study that chapter, and night what you need to do is within 1 hour just revise all the things which you studied from morning to evening, so that when you revise on the very same day, you'll make sure that you remember it for long and it'll be easy for you during exam also, okay? And the other thing is if you feel you are getting distracted with studying, then do one thing, concentrate more on quant, take 1 2 hours break and then go to next section. And then for example, I'm not feeling to do quantitative problems continuously, then what I need to do is morning I'm doing quant, then afternoon I should shift to general awareness, evening I have to shift to some other topic, and then reasoning, like that. You know, keep shifting the topics and keep shifting the sections so that you will feel concentrated and you will feel interest to practice it more, okay? So don't sit with the same subject and don't sit with the same chapter all over the day. And another thing is, don't compare yourself with others, don't compare with your friends who are scoring high, because it will affect your confidence. So, and another tip I would like to give is whatever formulae are important for the quantitative aptitude, make sure you note down in a short notes, a book like this, maintain a book like this, and make sure you note down your all the important formulae and all the important concepts in the in this kind of books, and before sleeping just revise everything every day, like morning once you wake up revise them, and night before you sleep revise them, so that at the time of exam you will remember it like in a seconds. Okay, it really works, trust me. And coming to the concepts which you have to focus on is the general awareness, current affairs, GK questions. Most of the people who attempts this exam will be losing marks in general awareness, so concentrate more on the general awareness questions and current affairs. And coming to current affairs, 6 to 8 months of current affairs you should have in your mind. And I have done a video on the current affairs recently, which covers the last 6 months current affairs, so you can check out in my channel. And during exam, what you need to do is start solving from easy section. Okay, if you feel English has easy section, start solving from that section, so that at last you will be having more time, because easy questions you'll be taking very less time, so you'll solve all these questions easy, like quickly. So that at last what happens is you'll be having more time for the difficult section. It really helps. And you can score more. And if you want to score more in this particular exam, concentrate more on previous papers, mock tests, and the short and the formulae, like the important formulae. So these three things, once you make sure you follow these three, you'll automatically score high in this exam and you'll crack the exam. And the thing is, if you want to guess the answer, don't do it at all, because the marks which you get also you may lose, because you know, instead of guessing, just leave the question, leave the nothing happens, because this kind of guesses will influence your marks, affect your marks, reduce your marks. So as this is a bank exam, what you need to do is you have to concentrate on that particular bank, and you have to see the sectional cutoff, and make sure you are aware of the pattern of the exam, syllabus of the exam, and sectional cutoff and the overall cutoff of the exam, because every year these kind of things will be changing. So, and while coming to the preparation, follow only standard books, okay? Because there will be many books which mislead the students, okay? So make sure you follow only standard books. So that's it for today, and make sure that you make a strict schedule and stick to that schedule, and make sure you complete your study within that particular limit. Okay, if I want to complete 5 chapters within this 2 days, I have to do that. Okay, so you have to achieve your goal which you set for every day or weekly. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such videos. And like and share this video with all your friends. Last 6 months current affairs video is in the link which is in description below. And if you have any queries, feel free to comment below in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Thanks for watching. All the best for your exam.